today. I'm Amanda Shelton. This year, Guampedia published their book, Fomalhaut Guahan, Women in Guam History, a biography of 28 women who have left their mark on our island's history. Guam has a rich legacy of strong women leaders who have advanced business, academia, politics, and healthcare on our island. The women of the 35th Guam Legislature, the first female majority legislature in the entire country, are proud to present to you readings from this book so we may celebrate and honor the contributions women have made to our island. Siduas Masi, and we hope you enjoy.
Elizabeth Bell Pangolinan Paris Areola led a life of outspoken advocacy. She served as a six-term Guam senator who championed legislation in favor of anti-abortion and anti-gambling policy, while simultaneously working to create the legacy that is the Guam Preservation Trust. After graduating as salutatorian from George Washington High School, Elizabeth left Guam to pursue a Bachelor of Arts degree from Rosemont College in Pennsylvania. Once she earned her teaching certificate, she returned to Guam in 1952. In 1954, she married attorney Joaquin C. Areola, and together they had eight children, three daughters, Jacqueline, Anita, and Lisa, and five sons, Vincent, Franklin, Michael, Joaquin Jr., and Anthony. While raising their children, she continued to actively engage in community work by serving on the Territorial Board of Education and the University of Guam Board of Regents. Her presence in the political sphere advanced through numerous activities with the Democratic Party of Guam, leading her to be elected as the first president of the Women's Democratic Party of Guam. This presence, coupled with her pious service as the president of the Christian Mothers Island Board, led to Bishop Felix Burchell Flores asking her to co-chair the campaign against legalizing gambling. Supported by the network of Christian mothers, Elizabeth set out to educate families on the detrimental effects of legal gambling while also engaging in rallies. This effort became a catalyst for her subsequent work as an island leader who perceived the effects of modernization as reflecting a decline of the moral fiber of Guam. In 1982, Elizabeth was elected to the Guam Legislature, where she served for the next 12 years. Using her platform that focused on protecting our families, Elizabeth brought national attention to the issue of abortion. In the early 1990s, she introduced legislation to prohibit abortion on Guam and outlaw pro-choice counseling to pregnant women. The Guam abortion law was deemed one of the most restrictive laws in the nation and was challenged by the American Civil Liberties Union in Guam courts, citing that the law infringed on the right of free speech. Interestingly, one of Elizabeth's daughters, attorney Anita Areola, sided with the ACLU. Although the law was struck down in the Federal District Court on Guam, the ruling highlighted the intertwined nature of religion, politics, and culture in Guam society, and the complex relationships between women, especially mothers and daughters, in Chamorro culture. Known as the Mother of Historic Preservation, Elizabeth authored the Guam Preservation Trust legislation in 1990. This law assigns Guam's building permit fees to GPT to pay for the preservation of historic sites. Elizabeth also served as legislative secretary and chaired the Committee on Youth, Senior Citizens, and Cultural Affairs. In 1995, she was appointed by Governor Carl Gutierrez to the Guam Museum, where she served as its executive director. Elizabeth Areola left a legacy of altruistic ambition, underscored by her commitment to her faith. Her spirit endures in her children.
Guampedia's book, Fomalhaut Guahan, Women in Guam History, and all the posters you've seen in this program are available for purchase online at guampediashop.com. By sharing the story of their lives, we are writing the story of women back into Guam history. In this way, we honor and celebrate the generations of women who have helped shape our island and shape our dreams. Siduas Masi for watching.